Oppression is defined as prolonged cruel or unjust treatment or control. The word comes from the Latin root opprimere, meaning press down. And who likes the idea of that? Oppressed peoples are people who experience oppression as a major part of their lives. This oppression can be political, economic, or social. Politically speaking, leaders of countries in their teens sometimes set laws that discriminate unfairly against a particular group of people. And economic oppression can take many forms. In some cases, people are denied equal opportunity to make a living based on their sex, nationality, race, or religion. In other cases, people's livelihoods are completely controlled through the illegal practice of slavery, forced labor, which is sometimes referred to as bonded labor. Whatever it's called, it's not good and it's not right. People groups are oppressed socially when they are denied access to services, harassed, or made to fear for their safety. All of these things can create distinctions between people where no distinction should exist. After all, we believe that all people deserve the same respect, understanding, and opportunity. So who does oppression affect and how? Anybody, anywhere can be impacted by oppression, though most often it's the poor and socially marginalized. Groups of people can be oppressed by those with power, often backed by the threat of violence. For example, in some countries, women's rights are severely limited or altogether absent, making it very difficult for them to have a voice and be able to speak to their own needs or pursue their own desires. Another example is when an individual's rights under the law are ignored and they are refused protection. Enslaved brick kiln workers are a sad example of this. As we think about others who face oppression, it might be best to think of ourselves in their shoes. When we think of it that way, it's a lot harder to ignore. Unfortunately, if oppression continues to be ignored, then it will become normal, when what we really want is for it to end. How can the world change? People of privilege need to take a stand and use their power and platforms to drive change. Laws should be put in place and enforced to protect the rights of the poor and marginalized. People can be more accepting of people and empathetic to the hardships that others face. In fact, that can start with you. So what can you do? First, take time to consider the people around you. Are any of them in situations of oppression? Consider how you can be a voice for someone whose voice has been undermined or silenced altogether. Finally, be sure to check out Katoa's projects related to oppressed peoples. Learn all you can, vote, and have your say in which project you believe Katoa should support. Oh, and one last thing. Your voice matters, so be sure to share your vote on social media and encourage others to join our movement that is seeing people everywhere help people everywhere. Because simply stated, people everywhere matter.